no place to look other than Jesus, turning our eyes to him, and that's what we're doing in our service this morning, and we pray that every part of this service will help you to accomplish that goal, turning your eyes upon Jesus.
Amen.
sanctuary choir for just leading us in our worship time today. We depend so much on their ministry, and they're always faithful in their time of preparation and in their time of presentation. And we are blessed through the sanctuary choir using the gift that God has given them to just be a part of our worship, but an important part of our worship. It really is. And we welcome you this morning as you come to share in this service. And this is one that I've been saying to you that I've been looking forward to for several weeks, and just feel like this is the Lord's timing, His leading this morning to speak to any of us and who've had difficult times, whatever that may be. And as I look at our church family, I realize that very few people are being spared. It seems like everyone is dealing with something of different degrees. So we welcome you this morning to the Lord of life and the Lord of love. As we come to worship, if you're visiting, it's good to have you with us today. Special place in our church family, special place in our heart. And we just pray that you know that you're a part of God's family. I do want to point out a couple of special greetings this morning. Is Orly, thank you. Amen. We should have known you were not going to be out very long. I have to tell you about Ms. Orly in the hospital. I've watched TV through the years, and I've never been impressed with TV patients. They always look too prim and proper. You know, not a hair out of place, nothing. I mean, I've never seen, in my visit in the hospital, a patient looked as good as the ones on TV until I visited Ms. Orly. I'm telling you, I think she just looked absolutely every hair in place, and I said, you sure you've had surgery? But we just so thankful that you're back with us. And I want you to welcome is Marty Harding. Marty is the wife of a man who was my barber for 40 years or more. And Brother Warren and I had some wonderful times together. Brother Marty and Warren are believers. They love the Lord. And in my years of visiting with Warren and getting my hair trimmed, we had some good times, some fun times. I said something to him one day about, you're responsible for me being good looking. And he mumbled something about not being a magician. Then when the hair started changing colors, I said something about, with the heavy frost last night, some of it's still in my hair. And he said, yeah, and it's going to be a whole lot more than that, too. And, well, don't you have some shoe polish or something you can put on it to help? So, yeah, I'll fix you up. So we had a great time. But Brother Warren went home to be with the Lord, and Ms. Marty had come this morning to share with us in our worship service. And I trust before we depart, you'll have the opportunity to share a personal word of greeting with her. With that, we'll dismiss our children for their worship time. And our scripture this morning is taken from the book of Hebrews, chapter 4. And we'll be reading the last three verses in this chapter. Stand with me as we honor the reading of God's word. Seeing then that we have a great high priest that is passed into the heavens, Jesus the Son of God, let us hold fast our profession. For we have not an high priest which cannot be touched with the feeling of our infirmity, but was in all points tempted like as we are, yet without sin. Let us therefore come boldly unto the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in time of need. Father, we know that life has a way of presenting difficult and challenging moments. Sometimes Lord, we question whether or not we will survive, whether we can compete. But we know that the scripture is very clear. You said your grace is sufficient, always has been, always will be. And it's not in us, but it's what Jesus Christ does in our lives that gives us the strength and the courage to go forward. When human nature doesn't really feel like we want to do that. This morning we come knowing that you have promised to meet us here in a special way. You have something for our hearts. You have something for our spirits. You have something, Lord, that only you can give, and something that we definitely and desperately need. Thank you for being the Lord of life and the Lord of love. Thank you for being the Lord of salvation, to give to everyone that assurance of eternal life. We come into your presence this morning to worship you, to magnify your precious name. Father, we ask you to lead us, to guide us in every part of this service, that whatever we do, your name will be magnified. In that precious name we pray. Amen. I know that a number of our church family have had difficult, trying times. Some have had family members who have gone to be with the Lord. And the years have taught me that singing songs about heaven can be emotional for anyone who has experienced something like that. But I must say they can also be songs of comfort and songs of peace and assurance. And I trust as we sing these songs this morning about heaven, you'll be encouraged and you'll be comforted to know that heaven is real. And that's our home. That's where the Lord is. That's where we're going to be one day, joining him. Then to lead us as we sing.
Good morning. Our opening hymn this morning is What a Day That Will Be.